Hey there, welcome back to our channel Vaishvi for some stories. The story we are going to listen today is a story of just every other person in today's world. It doesn't need much of an explanation.
It is dark all over. He's stuck beneath her blanket. He is gasping heavily. He's trying to find a way out. The blanket seems just endless. He cannot find the hem. He is completely hemmed by the vast weight of the blanket. He so dreadfully wants to come out of it. It is suffocating and starkly dark. Feverish gasping, dark and stuck inside the never-ending blanket, is making him feel more nervous. His heart is plunging and he has a sinking feeling down his chest. His sight is blurring and he has started fainting. He is losing all of the hopes of escaping this trap ever. A sudden beam of white light flashes on his eyes. His descending consciousness gains courage to pull him out of the swamp of the lost hope which was hitherto pulling him inside. His smothered self follows the light trace to the way out. It was warm inside and it is cold outside. It is dark again. He has a feeling of being caged in a cubicle walled from every direction. He can sense it. He can see nothing. He starts running all over the room to find a way out. He hits something solid on his stomach and falls on the ground. He cannot collect himself to get up again and walk. He starts crawling in nervousness. He has no clue of the direction. His senses are all hacked, jagged, numbed. He is just randomly moving in any direction. He now hits his head with something. He tries to feel what is it, but cannot. He can know nothing. The thought of losing direction and touch made him more vulnerable. Grabbing his stomach with one hand, it is still painful, and supporting his body from the other, he throws himself off the ground to get up and start, and he starts swaying in any direction. In the way he rams a solid heavy thing, he has already wounded himself a lot. He anyhow manages to reach the wall. He starts beating the wall to find any door or recess to find an escape, but all the efforts are not the worth. Suddenly, white light illuminates the room. Everything is white. The bed and the blanket he was lying on are all white. Everything else in the room is wooden and brown. Furniture in the room is all scattered. He turns to run in the direction of source of light, but the light is dimming and is vanishing. It vanishes. It grows dark again. He again runs into something, most probably a table. He runs for the wall again. He is breathing heavily. He wants to scream for help, but his voice is choked in his throat. He cannot. A gradual noise starts to grow behind him. The noise is faint. It is growing louder. He tries to move away from it. He closes his ears and eyes in terror. A sensation moves all over his body. He is in jitters. The voice grows more prominent. He closes his eyes and ears more fiercely. He squats down, wishing the noise to cease. But what is happening is the opposite. He opens his eyes in his bed. He looks around. Safe in his bedroom, in his apartment, with everything in the usual setting. The room is lit by sunlight. He extends his hand to turn down the alarm ringing on his mobile phone. He felt relaxed for a while. It was a dream, a nightmare. He looks at the time. It is the time for him to get up, otherwise he would be late for work. He wakes up and leaves his bed. While brushing, the dream crosses his mind. Like any other person, we sometimes think about our dreams after waking up, especially when they are scary, and so does he. What was the dream I saw? He puts pressure on his mind to remember what was the dream while he's still brushing. Now I remember why I had this dream. It doesn't have any connection with me anymore. He smiles and kept on brushing. Who is this person? This person, his name is Alfred Oregon. He's a successful man in his 30s. He is the executive manager at an MNC. His office is situated in the most busy parts of the city and is inside a huge building on the 33rd floor. He has a good reputation in the office. He is a reputed and respected personality. He is admired and loved by all of the colleagues. He is a pleasant person to be around. He carries happiness wherever he goes. He is famous for his sense of humor. Alfred has a lovely, lively persona. His behavior with the colleagues and the other staff was nice and polite. His seniors and bosses are happy with him. He is hardworking too. He has a good job. He is doing well in his life. He is earning a handsome amount and has no financial issues at all. This dream was definitely not related to him. How it can be he was doing? Yeah, I know that money is not a gauge for happiness. It cannot be. Your happiness cannot be measured by the amount of money you have. So let us dig into his personal life. His emotional space has been in turmoil for over a year. Something was not right. His wife Jenna was a batchmate in college and they met through a common friend. And they dated for 3 years. Then they broke up because they had to move to different part of cities. Their relationship was not working out. Long distance relationships are hard to keep and they were having problems in relationship. And so that's why they broke up. After a few years, Alfred got lucky and bagged a decent job in his own city and he came back, where he again met his ex-girlfriend in a party. Jenna had recently broke up with his boyfriend and was emotionally wrecked. She was currently single and he had been single after breaking up with her. Seeing each other after a long time was both awkward and emotional. From that night, their love story took another flight. They got married after a few years and now they are married for 10 years. After a few years of gradual change in relationship is inevitable. It cannot be avoided and it happens with everybody and it happened with them also. And this was further mixed with career prospects of Alfred. To their first baby, Alfred was at a turning point in his career. He had to work hard to grab the opportunity and seize it from everyone else in hand. This needed investment of energy and time for work. He spent less time witnessing his child's growth and more in the growing graph of his career. Got promoted, his financial status got elevated. In the professional front, everything was running smooth and straight. And this meant that Jane was taking care of the child alone. She was parenting their child when Alfred was mostly away from work. Or even when he was at home, he was in the office in spirits. Seems this is the story of the modern career oriented world. Yeah, it is. The love that they had between them was slowly diminishing and they were getting constrained in their own worlds, which were farther away from each other. Jenna's world was centered around the child. She started thinking that the child was only her and Alfred's life was concentrated at his job. This was his time. It was then or never. Jenna understood this. She knew that Alfred is doing this all for them, for their child's future and for their future. She was an understanding wife, definitely. But she would only complain but not fight. This went for a long time until she cracked one day. From then, their lives were in turmoil. As a few instances where they talked or fought, there was no significant heart-to-heart talk between them. This went on for 5 long years. His career started settling down. He reached to a high point in his career. Now he could find time for his family. He knew that he owed an apology to his wife and child. But Jenna was not convinced. Someone very wise said these lines to me long before, that the person who goes out and meets other people where the world changes away from the place of scenario tends to forget every awful incident. But the person who stays at home and is left in the same settings where all the awful incidents occurred, it becomes hard for this person to forget things. And Jenna was at such a place. But Jenna wanted her marriage to last. She was understanding. She understood her husband's zeal. She always appreciated him for his hard work. And she decided to give her marriage a second chance. Like they did years before by giving their relationship a second chance. And it was worth it. And so, they had recently came back from a heartwarming holidays where they spent quality time with each other and with their child. They both realized what they missed these years and so their marriage showed signs of resurrection and now everything was turning to the sunny side. So when everything was going good, now there's no chance that this dream was any way related to Alfred. Definitely the dream has no correspondence with his life, not at all. Not all the dreams have relationship with your life. Dreams are dreams. Humans have always tried to find a hidden meaning behind them or fantasized about them, predicting the future. But in this story, I don't think it finds any space. Not at all. So, after holidays, this is the first day in office. The day has just started for Alfred. After a long holiday, he is back to work. He reached the office and is greeted by everyone with the same warmth as usual. He has to look into everything that happened in the office in his absence, and so he gets lost in his work.
I know, nothing much happened, right? But surely something will. Stay tuned to us and keep listening. If you like the story, then give it a thumbs up, comment down any suggestions that you have, and please subscribe to us. Now you can follow us on Instagram too. The link is in the description. See you guys next Sunday. Till then, we are Inshue. Do not forget the name.